excited because it's a big tradition here in Chicago and just with my family. And I'm really excited for everyone to be here and just have fun.
Across the country, the arrival of spring marks the beginning of prom season.
You smiling now. Take that picture.
That annual rite of passage for teenage high school students. But in Chicago's African-American community, there is a unique ritual that accompanies the prom. Extravagant pre-prom gatherings where friends, family, community leaders, and residents gather to greet and celebrate high school students just before they depart to go to their school-sponsored parties.
Hey, Jumbo Jumbo, we can party all week long. Oh, Jumbo Life.
I call it a prom reception, but the teens call it a prom send-off. And it's very common in just something that, I said, in the last 20 years has been very a common thing. It's like a rites of passage for teenagers to seniors graduating, going to college.
These events have been growing in popularity and have gotten bigger and bigger. Many times, they are bigger than the prom itself.
Where your purse?
We have a DJ, we have a professional photographer, we have different foods here so that everyone could enjoy themselves and sit down and eat and have a lovely night and just come here to celebrate.
It encourages the young people. It shows the young people how the older people can get along. Don't get me wrong, we fuss and fights, but when it comes for us to get together, we come together.
The gatherings are considered exclusive and crucial social events. They attract dozens and sometimes hundreds of adults who pile up in their relatives' houses, yards. They stand along the blocks to celebrate and party.
People have their phones and taking pictures, and you invite people because it's kind of like she's not in a debutante or in a cotillion. So this is kind of like when you get the community together and say, come over, come see her. Because some people you work with, they hear you talk about your daughter. Some people haven't seen her since she was little. You change jobs and people want to see her. So you have all the community, so everyone comes.
There is live music, food, and sometimes a dress code. The adults and friends take pictures of and with the students. They cheer out loud as the teens emerge in their formal wear. Then they spend an hour or so mingling with the teens before they depart for their formal event. Some of the adults will linger for hours after the teenagers leave, reliving the proms of their youth. No one knows exactly how these prom send-offs began in the Black community, but they have evolved into a ritual. These ceremonies give families a reason to highlight their children and fuss over them. It gives them a reason to be over the top, celebratory, while all dressed up and fancy. The ceremonies are more sophisticated and elaborate than the prom. They are meaningful because the students get to strut their stuff in front of their friends, family, and neighbors that are closest to them, not just their classmates.
Everybody is telling you when you come out, oh, you look so nice, so beautiful, your makeup is wonderful, and that makes you like so happy, and as a high school senior, you want that.